Thank you so much for joining us here on the web. Nearly everyone from the Greenland Police Department joined a massive crowd in Washington, D.C. for a special ceremony yesterday to honor fallen officers, including Greenland's former police chief. A crowd of close to 20,000 turned out last night for a candlelight vigil at the Law Enforcement Officers Memorial. Greenland officers are in D.C. to pay tribute to former Chief Michael Maloney, and they've been joined by a strong New Hampshire contingent.
I think he would have thought it was beautiful. All of the people that are there to share that moment, it's been very special, and I think he would have enjoyed that.
Later today, Greenland officers will tour the Capitol and meet with members of the New Hampshire delegation. The week culminates on Wednesday with a service at the memorial. Flags will fly at half-staff on Wednesday for National Peace Officers Memorial Day. Friday is Law Enforcement Memorial Day here in the Granite State. Well, a crash involving a state police cruiser shut down a section of Route 114 in Goffstown last night. Shortly before 10 o'clock, police say trooper Mark Doerr was heading north when he collided with another car driven by 24-year-old Brian Vitrone of Goffstown. Vitrone was taken to the hospital for evaluation. The trooper was not injured. The cause of the crash is under investigation. For the second time in a week, thieves hit a downtown Manchester jewelry store. The alarm went off at Pearson's Jewelry just after 3:30 Monday morning. The front glass was shattered and several display cases were taken. Watches, rings, necklaces, they're now missing. There was a similar break-in at the same business exactly 1 week earlier. Well, this morning a lawsuit is pending against the state of New Hampshire filed by a group of homeless men after they were told to leave the public land that they've been living on. The plaintiff's attorneys say that many of the 150 homeless people in Concord end up living on public land when shelters shut down in the spring. One group living off of Hazen Drive say they keep things tidy and they don't cause any trouble. The camp is on public land, which until a few weeks ago wasn't posted. But when signs went up, three of the men living here enlisted the help of the ACLU to file suit.
I don't think anyone has a problem with the police enforcing laws and punishing disruptive behaviors. What we do have a problem with is this idea of punishing status. Because you are poor, you have to be displaced, and that's un-American.
Those men were supposed to leave by May 15th, but because of the lawsuit, they can stay until the matter is heard in court. Well, the Powerball jackpot is now at $350 million. That's the third largest Powerball prize in history. Your chances of winning are about 1 in 175 million. Tickets cost $2 each. The next drawing is tomorrow night, and good luck to you. That's it for your morning webcast. Thanks for joining us, and have a great day.